We are back with organizing expert Julie Morgenstern, who offered to help out a member of the TAM fam, Joanna Cox Morin, a self-described messy mom who is desperate to get organized.
Hey, Joanna. So nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. So I'm home with our three kids who are 3, 5, and 7. They were all in full-time school, so this is quite a change.
So one of the challenges is just managing the school activities across three ages from three different sets of teachers.
Right. I try and go upstairs and do my work there in our bedroom, and they stay down here. Lots of screens, because it's pretty much the only thing that I can guarantee myself at least 45 straight minutes of uninterrupted work.
Do you have a school space?
It's our dining room. With school being indefinitely out, we no longer have a place to eat. And so now we've kind of shifted to eating in the toy room.
Okay.
All right, pantry. My aunt and uncle took it upon themselves to organize it. So if I hadn't had that a month ago, it would be a lot worse. This is my office.
I'm looking for the office. Yeah, where is the office?
Here's my office. I sit on my bed with my laptop.
If this is where you're going to work, you 100% need a desk. How would it feel for you if you actually came up, closed the door, and you had a space for your work?
I'd probably be more productive.
Good. I'm excited to help solve the problems.
Let's see the after here.
I told her to clear out that rocking chair, which she said was never being used, get a table and a chair and some trays to have her work stationed and organized and ready for when she could sit down, and even a whiteboard, because she only gets short blocks of time to work. And I said, get a whiteboard and break your work down into 45-minute chunks. So when you get 45 minutes, you sit down, you know exactly, I'm going to do this next 45-minute task. And she could make the most of those found blocks of time.
She looks like she did a great job. Joanna, how do you feel? How did you feel after following these tips?
Oh, it was fantastic. I mean, one of the hardest things about the last month or so has been the lack of control that we have. You know, everything in our lives is kind of determined for us. And that definitely trickled down into the house and the stress of that. So this was great because she was telling me things that I could do, I had control over, I could change. And, you know, I think it's going to translate into, you know, just happiness in general, but, you know, better work productivity. And yeah, and my daughter's happy to get her travel desk back. So.
Tell me about the kitchen. I mean, my cabinets are closed, but my kitchen cabinet pantries look a lot like, you can't see it, but they look a lot like the problem you were having. Tell me about the problem, Joanna.
Well, the biggest problem, because I'm not used to having the kids home all day. And so the pantry wasn't really a temptation for them, but now that they're home all day, I would find wrappers and things just thrown at the bottom. They would just go in there and get whatever they want and come out. And I had all the kind of dangerous treats at their eye level. So, you know, all the candy, all the processed treats that I put one of in their lunch was now, you know, it was like a full buffet and the wrong snacks when I wasn't paying attention.
Because it was right there for them. So Julie, right. What did you see there and what was the solution you offered her?
So what I told her is to, first of all, move all of the snacks out of reach, not in reach, up on the pantry, and get a snack bin for each kid, label it, and determine the snacks at the beginning of the day, and then have those snacks predetermined. And what they want a snack, they go to their bin. It's already set up for them. And she didn't even need to lock the pantry, but it completely took them away from the pantry and they just go to their snack bin.
It was a bit of a shock the first time that they went, and now it's canned vegetables where the candy used to be. But they, which is fun. But now in their snack trays, they like different things. And so they look at it as like, ooh, my curated little box of things that I like.
I
and it's different
that.
From
That's
the other.
That's a great idea.
And now they don't have to bother me every 5 minutes for a snack.